Oh, but okay, this is the end of the video, but I'm saying this in the beginning. I have a little tip if you want to get a vintage Levi's Sherpa denim jacket. Wait for that till the end before you buy any Levi's Sherpa denim jacket. Very scared that I'm going to be late for my flight, though. Flight leaves at 5:40. It is 3:20 now. Normally, too, I'd wear something more fun than just a down jacket, like the other Levi Sherpa that we're talking about today. But I'm going to Dallas, Texas, where I will probably only need a denim jacket at most. It's supposed to be 75 there. So I'm just bringing one layer that I can pack easily on the plane. Also, denim jackets are really warm, and it's 29 degrees outside. Outside at 3:30 in the morning on a Wednesday. I don't think that
Morning.
This is not what a typical day looks like for me at all.
I was originally gonna do the review in Dallas, and then
here I go, off to bed in Dallas.
So, just pretend that whole thing never happened. Was it a waste of time? Maybe, but probably not. Anyways, you know the drill.
I'm gonna get right to the point because that was a very convoluted start to the video. So, the Levi's Sherpa jacket is one of my favorite jackets of all time. Also, their blanket line jacket, but they don't currently make that, I don't think. Just a straight up Type 3 with a blanket lining. But I always hear, you know, like old Levi's is better, the orange tabs, the big E's and stuff like that. They're collectible for a reason, not just because it's an old jacket, but because it was better quality, it was selvedge, it was raw back then. So I was always on the hunt for a size 38 Type 3 vintage dead stock jacket in general, just in general, no lining or anything. But I was sleeping right there, believe it or not, and so I just woke up and I was like, oh my God, I need to check eBay for a Levi's Sherpa denim jacket. And I did, and there was a dead stock 1970s size 38 Levi's Sherpa denim jacket from the 70s. And I was like, great. So it's not a big E, it's not an orange tab or anything like that, but it's the closest thing I could get to that. I kind of want to do a series comparing old Levi's to new Levi's, just because I think that'd be fun. Anyways, on to the actual meat and potatoes of this video. I'm actually not going to tell you the answer right away. A lot of my videos, I'm like, end of the day, great jacket. But since I'm comparing two jackets, I kind of want to break them both down. Obviously, one's a bit more interesting than the other because one of them you could pick up from your local Macy's right now. The other one, if you have a time machine, you could. Here we have a 1970s Levi's Sherpa Type 3 jacket, a 72605-0217. Again, like I said, not an orange tab, not a big E. I don't think it's anything crazy, but I should note real quick that I'm not gonna keep this jacket for a reason that you will find out shortly, but I'm not gonna keep it. I'm actually gonna sell it. I'm gonna put it on eBay, I think, a week from this video. If any of you wanna buy it, let me know, because I'd rather give it to a subscriber than just some random eBayer. And upfront about the price, here's what I paid on eBay. I think it was like $275, $277. Oh, this is a good transition. If you want it, follow me on Instagram at 8th weekday and shoot me a DM. What you should also do though is subscribe to this channel. Again, follow me on Instagram, like this video, comment. I love comments. I'll comment back. Unless this video goes for some reason crazy viral, then I'll stop responding because I'm famous. I don't have time for that. The 1970s Sherpa jacket. First thing I noticed was that although it's not washed, it's very crispy and everything, it's very light blue compared to all the raw denim I have and that I've seen. It's very light blue. It's not mid-wash, but it's like two tones down from that. Maybe it even is mid-wash. I don't know. There's not really a ton of character, which is kind of what you see on Levi's. It's just very, and just American denim in general, just very uniform denim, not a lot of slub. There is a few little not even really nep. It's not like a knot in the thread. It's just a little tuft of the weft coming through. So you see like little tiny threads coming up through the warp of white. So it's pretty cool. If you buy this jacket and you follow me, please send me a picture after you wash it. Like actually message it to me on Instagram or something like that. I would love to see it and maybe do a little follow-up on it. And I don't know, it's like it's like I'm giving up a baby for adoption and I'm like, oh, let me know if it's cute. The general fit of this jacket is a little beefier. I'll get into why when I do the actual comparison, but you can see the comparison between me wearing these two right here. The fit feels pretty much the same, but it's out a little bit more. It's got a little more heft to it, which again, during the comparison of these two jackets, we're gonna dive into that one. Let me tell you, we're gonna be swimming. And finally, the reason that I'm selling this jacket is because there's no hand pockets. I can understand why, for whatever reason, for the Type 2, the Type 1, the Type 3, no lining, Levi's was like, no hand pockets. Just maybe it wasn't in fashion then. I don't know, maybe they considered, well, they used to call denim jackets blouses, so maybe they considered it more of a shirt, so no pockets. For whatever reason, I don't know. But when you think about making a jacket with a Sherpa lining in it, you think, oh, this is probably gonna be used when it's cold. We should probably protect the fingies, you know? Something along those lines. No hand pockets. So it's not a deal for me. I was gonna go to a tailor and get hand pockets in, but I was like, you know, I have so many jackets. I would rather sell it to someone that follows the channel. When we compare it to the new pre-washed Levi's Premium Sherpa jacket in black, just because I'm gonna keep this jacket. So I was like, well, I'll get a color that I want. I don't have any black jackets, whatever. I don't have to defend myself to you. Except Phil, because Phil called me out because I didn't have a good hamper. So the modern jacket. Now there's two levels of getting a Levi's Sherpa jacket. There's the premium version and the non-premium version. I did a lot of research to find out why they say it's premium. I think it's also $30 more expensive to get the premium version. And basically, comes down to two things. From what I can find, there may be something else. There's more stitches per inch and all the sewing, so it's tighter sewn. And they use a leather patch. That's it. I was hoping for a few different things. One, different denim, and two, thicker Sherpa lining, which again, we'll get into in a second. We're gonna get into a lot in a second, as you can probably tell. But yeah, that's all the premium mark does. So honestly, you could probably get the not premium one, pay a little bit less money, and if you don't mind, the fewer stitches per inch, and the non-leather patch, the like thick Levi's cardboard ones, you're probably fine. No fading yet, I've only had it for like a month, and also, I don't know, I'd said this in my last video too, but do black Levi's fade? That sounds dumb because obviously black denim does fade if it's dyed with sulfur, but I don't know what the fit compared to the 70s one is. It doesn't feel that much different. It's definitely a little slimmer, a little closer to the body. Again, not a lot, and for a very specific reason, which it's almost time to get into all that stuff I've been putting aside. And finally, with these this B-roll, I was trying to see if I could lift up the pocket and throw my phone in. I was like, that would be a cool B-roll shot, but I couldn't. I tried like three times and gave up. Sometimes you just have to realize it's time to give up. Anyways though, the 2020 premium Levi's Sherpa denim jacket in black has beautiful, luscious, warm hand pockets. So nice. Of course you have the booby pockets on both of them. That's obviously a staple of the Type 3 and even the Type 2, half a staple in the Type 1. Maybe people were mono boobed back then and it was more important to do something else, put the belt on the back of the jacket or something like that. Okay, so now the nitty gritty. I want to compare the premium modern jacket to just a regular 1970s older jacket, and without comparison, besides the hand warmers, the 1970s jacket is a different beast entirely, which I was really surprised about. I thought there would be some differences. I didn't think the older jacket would be that much better for a lot of reasons too. It's not just like one thing, it's just a better built jacket, which is really sad obviously, but taking the two of them and putting them next to each other, I did it a few times and I wore them both and I was just like, oh yeah, you know, this is fine, whatever. When I was doing the B-roll though, and I was comparing the two jackets like side by side, so I would hold one then immediately grab another for like 2 hours, I was just like, oh my goodness, this 1970s jacket is leagues ahead of the other one. It's ahead, but it's behind. What does that mean? The first thing is that the 1970s jacket has a higher stitch per inch. As far as I can tell, I put them really close together and I was like, one, two, three, four. But the stitching is a lot more dense. It's a lot closer together. It's pretty clear when you look at it. I wouldn't say double the amount of stitches, but there are definitely more stitches. On the contrary though, it looks like the stitching, the cleaning up afterwards is a little messier. There's still some loose threads, but again, in the 70s, they're probably just like, jacket's done, here you go, boss, and they gave it to, you know, Mr. Levi, and he sold it to your mom. Now, when I was talking about the bulkiness of the 70s jacket and the slimness of the premium jacket, that is mainly due to the fact that the Sherpa on the 1970s jacket is pretty dramatically thicker than the premium jacket. Now, I can't believe I did that. There's so many YouTubers I see, It always drives me nuts where they're like, hey guys, how are you doing? My name is Michael here. Today I'm gonna teach you how to do men's fashion, how to look good, how to get girls. They always do this. I don't know why, but I just did it. Anyways, the Sherpa is definitely thicker, like dramatically thicker. You could see the comparison I did here. And that was really surprising. That's actually the reason I got the premium jacket, the modern premium jacket, just because I thought that Sherpa was thicker than the non-premium version. I think they're actually the same. But when I got this 1970s jacket, I knew right away I was gonna, you know, like do tests and stuff like that. But just by opening the jacket and like pressing my hand against it, I was like, wow, this has a lot higher loft. And obviously what that means is this is a dramatically warmer jacket, except for your hands, which will be frozen and frostbitten by the time you realize. I did have a feeling that was gonna be the case, but I just didn't expect it to be that much to the point where it makes it look like the 1970s jacket is cut bulkier, because it may be slightly, but really the only reason I think it's cut bulkier is because there is so much more loft to that Sherpa, which, like I said, translates to a lot more warmth. I don't really have a fair estimate, but I could say 5 to 10 degrees, maybe a little bit more. It's definitely a warmer jacket. When you put it on, it feels like you're putting a heater on, like a little heated vest. And finally, more in this jacket's core, the insulation on the arms. It's never usually Sherpa or wool or anything like that, just because you're putting your sleeves in there. You usually have long sleeves on in the winter, or even if you don't, if it's wool, that's gonna irritate your arms, probably, just because, you know, your arms are nakedly flowing about in the jacket. So it's usually lined with some like quilted polyester lining, nothing really too crazy. And again, I didn't expect anything to be different here between the two jackets, but there was something different. And I do want to qualify this by saying, I don't know if maybe technology changed, maybe there's better, more efficient insulation in the modern Levi's jacket versus the old one, but the 70s Levi's jacket, the insulation in the arms is actually tangibly, I don't really know if that's the right word. It sounds good though. I noticed on a lot of my videos, I just say the completely wrong word for things. I pulled out a bathroom scrubber and I said plunger and no one corrected me. I just was like, oh, and I got the plunger, put it away, nothing. Anyways, the insulation in the arms on the 1970s jacket is dramatically thicker than the modern day premium jacket, to the point where if you put your arm inside the sleeve like this and you pinch, you can feel the fact in the 1970s jacket you're pushing down some insulation. You can feel that it's pretty stiff and it's there. When you do that with the modern jacket, you can't really feel anything. It just feels like there's a little bit of nylon and then the denim itself. I do have to say that since this jacket isn't washed, maybe if I washed it, it would spread out and soften up, but I don't think so. I felt like I could feel the plush insulation. It feels like a very thin, like continuous styrofoam that goes around the arm or something like that, and it feels just a lot thicker. You can't really see it, it's hard to show, but it's definitely a lot more present. But yeah, besides that, it's really just a much better jacket. And I don't know, maybe in the 70s it was priced accordingly, maybe it wasn't, but compared to today's modern jackets, I was pretty surprised, because one of the things I've been doing for a while is buying denim jackets with Sherpa linings. Before I made YouTube videos, and I was just checking the pile of the jackets because I was like, I need to find the thickest one so it's really warm. That's why I had the free note cloth one with real shearling liner, but it was cut too short. It's very tough to find a thick lined Sherpa or shearling denim jacket. Okay, so the tip, like I said, the 2020 modern Levi's premium type 3 Sherpa jacket, it's a great jacket. There's nothing wrong with it. For $128, it's a great modern day Sherpa jacket. You could get a Brave Star Sherpa lined denim jacket. It's not that much more, and it's selvedge and it's raw, so you have that. I actually haven't checked the pile of that Sherpa jacket yet, so I don't know about that one, but you know, Brave Star's a pretty cool company, so you're there. But that Levi's jacket, nothing inherently wrong with it. But when you put it up against the 1970s jacket, which again is basically double the price now to find one like I did on eBay, that's brand new though, so you could find one pre-worn. That's definitely a better jacket than the modern one, but no hand pockets. What the real good, what's the word? The best deal. I swear this wasn't on purpose, and I'm sparing you from something. I know the audio went down in quality. You know those things, it's like a classic TV trope, where someone's about to say something, then it like cuts or something goes wrong? This is what just, oh, prepare yourself, it's gonna be loud, but this is what just happened. The best deal. So the battery on my lavalier microphone died right as I was gonna tell you the best deal. I promise it's not a scam, I promise it's real. The best deal that I can find is a 1990s Sherpa denim jacket from Levi's. I think that is where they nailed it, because the quality of the 70s is still there in the jackets, and it has hand warmer pockets. So I think you could also get one from the late 80s, but basically, late 80s to 90s, perfect. The Sherpa pile is really high, There's hand warmer pockets. I don't know if you like the oversized fit. I know that's in fashion right now. That was also by far my most stolen jacket in college. It got stolen all the time. And I don't mean stolen like by a girl and she's like, oh my God, I'm so cold. Can I borrow your jacket? And I'm like, sure. And then she takes it home. I mean like I would wear the jacket to a party. It would get stolen from a party. I would have friends come over. Everybody would leave and my jacket would be gone. But symbolically, I gave that jacket to my girlfriend Taylor the last week of college, almost 2.5-3 years ago. Downside is though, obviously it's hard to find a dead stock one, so if you like raw denim jackets, that's kind of the tough part there. But anyways, I gotta go. It's the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. I wanna go home and see my mommy and daddy. So, goodbye.